Now we're going to take a look at, again, with the infighting, working out for our positions to get angles. Because the basics are to stay down on your front, pick a side, down the middle. But we're at war here. It's pretty much stupid for me to just want to stay down the middle. He can hit me just as much as I can hit him. Like most sports, I want to flank my man. I want to get around him. In boxing, these are small angles. So I want to get around him so I can shoot, and his target is away, so he can punch over there, but I'm still punching over here. So what we're going to do is this is going to be turning to the right side. So if I drop right, how do I turn my man out? So what we're going to do first is there's going to be a pivot, there's going to be a sidestep, and I'm going to scoop my man. So pivot, sidestep, and a scoop. So here's what we're going to do. So again, shoulder to shoulder. I'm in position. My base is wide. My right foot is slightly to the outside of his left foot, so that way my head is inside my base and I'm outside his firing range. My elbow is close to my body and I'm touching his elbow. If I'm too far away, two things. One is that that's too much leverage on my body to try and push him, and two, it doesn't set me up for that short shot I'm going to miss. But if my elbow is close to my body and my hand is on his elbow, then I know that I'm in short shot range. That's what we want to keep. So the first one we're going to do is a pivot. Again, wide base, sit down, root down in the big oak tree. Keep my right foot to the outside, his left foot slightly. I want to get a lower position. I'm going to take my elbow against my body, my hand on his elbow, and I turn him out like a door. I want you to think that his spine is a door hinge. I'm going to turn him like that. Just like that, back in position. And I turn him, just like that. So all I do is open the doorknob, right there. Now I want to be careful, because when I start getting my body into it and I change my position at the same time, a tendency is to push, I'm going to push you off balance, is to push him away from me. But I don't want to do that. The whole idea is to score shots against my opponent. So that's why I want to spin him like a top, around his spine. If I push too hard, I'm going to spin him, and his axis is going to be that back foot. He's going to be off balance, but I'm pushing him away. I want to keep him there with me. So, again, come on over here. I'm low. My base is wide. My base is just to the outside, so my head stays to the outside of his firing range. My elbow is close to my elbow, or to my body. My hand is on his. Now I'm going to step over when I push him. Do that again. I'm going to do it two more times over here. I'm over here, and I push, and back in position. And I push, and I'm back in position. Let's switch it over here. Good, so again, I'm low, my foot's to the outside of his foot, my head's outside of his firing range, I put my hand on his elbow, and I push, I spin him around that spine, and I push. Come on over here. And again, so watch it, his rotation should be right around his chest area, not over his foot. So I'm going to go here and push. Again, here, push. One more, down, push. Good. So now what this does is it's a sidestep. So come on over here actually, and it'll set up for the next move. So again, head to the other side of the firing range, foot slightly outside the firing range, outside of his foot. My hands are up, my elbow is on my body, hand on his elbow, and I push him away. Now it's a sidestep. So essentially, all I'm doing is if he's a train coming off the track, he's coming straight at me, all I'm doing is stepping off the track, let him go by me. That's all I'm doing. So I'm just helping him out a little bit, and push, and now as I set that foot down, I'm planted for that right uppercut, for the overhand right. Okay, so I plant my right foot, and I can shoot that right hand right there, or over top. Just watch you don't get the back of the head. You get called for it. So that's a sidestep. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to pivot on the next foot, or on the left foot. So that was a sidestep. The sidestep is I drop my weight to my right foot, I can turn into it. The other one is where I'm going to go toe-to-toe. I put my weight on my front foot, so I drop down, put my weight on my front foot, and spin out. I load my right shoulder or my left knee, so I have the left uppercut. So it looks like this. So again, same thing. I want to spin them like a top. Don't push them. And I'm going to go, I'm there for that one. Again, shoulder to shoulder. I'm here for that one. Toe to toe is very important. Because if I'm over here in the middle of his base, I'm going to turn into the middle of his firing range. I want to be outside his firing range as much as possible. So I'm toe to toe, right foot's on the outside of his base, head's inside my base, and I turn him out. Put my load, my right shoulder over my left knee, so I can get that left uppercut off. One more time. Position, spin out, and load up. Now come on over here. Again, we're in position, spin out, load up. Again, position, spin out, load up. So I load that right shoulder over my left leg and come up. Come on over here. Again, shoulder to shoulder, I spin them out, load that right shoulder over top of my left leg, hide behind my right hand, and drive that body up. Two more on that side. And I'm in position, load it up, right there. In position, load it up, right there. We have one more over here. And again, position and load. Position and load. Position, load my right shoulder, my left knee, and shoot that shot. Now that was two so far. That was your sidestep. Sidestep, load the right hand. Pivot. I'm loading for the left hand. Now it's going to be a simple scoop them and get out. So here I am. Again, in position. Now what I'm going to do is I'm in position, my weight is low, my base is wide, my foot's on the outside of his, my head's inside my base, looking good. I can just scoop this arm and turn out. Do that again. Come on up. Right here. So then again, I'm in position, scoop my arm, and turn him out. And one more. Keep my hands up on this one. I'm here. I scoop him out, and I turn him out. Good. So now let's go here, this position. So hands up, head down, I'm in position, base, I drop, scoop, and turn him out. Come on over here. Okay, hands up, head down, scoop, and turn it over. Come on back. One more. And scoop, and turn them over. Good, and then go there, here. Hands up, head down, and then I drop, scoop, and turn them over. Drop, scoop, and turn them out. One more. Drop, scoop, and turn them out. Now over here, let me see if you gotta do this one. And then I got drop, scoop, turn them out. Now the thing you wanna watch for is that a lot of people wanna do a dance. I scoop with the wrong arm. Keep this hand up. I have my left hand up. And I scoop with this hand to turn him out. A lot of people, when they drop, they want to go over here. I need that hand to be able to attack. So my hand stays up here, scoop, turn him out. Good. So quick review, come on up. I've got three things here. I've got sidestep. So again, position, hands up, head down. My base is wide. My foot's to the other side of him, my head's inside my base. I take my elbow on my body, hand on his elbow, turn him out with a side step, which loads up for the right hand. One more. Side step, right hand. The next one is going to be a pivot. I load on my weight on my left leg for my left uppercut. Again, up here, out of my body, hand to his elbow, turn out, and shoot the left uppercut. Left uppercut. And then the last one is a scoop and get out. So again, hands up, head down. I'm going to drop, scoop, and get out. One more. Drop, scoop, and get out. Just like that. Now that's our three positions for the right side.